Hi everyone, welcome to the next episode in our Research Essentials series for secondary students. So this episode focuses specifically on the six steps of research, so let's get started. Here we are on a page called Ergo, which is made and run by us at the State Library of Victoria, and it's made specifically for secondary students. So you can see up here in the Learn Skills area, we've got research skills, study skills, and essay writing skills. So all of those are going to be useful at different times of your studies. And also this section here, which is fantastic, is Explore History, and it's got lots of great information, lots of great interesting stories about Victorian history. And it's also got this For Teachers section here, which has great activities and lesson plans that you can do from school. So today we're focusing on the research skills. So you can see here, it's got the six steps of research, and don't be fooled by the babyish pictures. It is actually really good information. So your first step is to define the task, then locate information, select your resources, organize your notes, present the ideas, and evaluate your work. So if I click on the first step, define the task, it breaks it down and it actually tells me what that means. So in this section, we need to figure out how to understand the question, use what we already know, generate some questions, do some background reading. So you might do some background reading on something like Wikipedia, and like we touched on in the last episode, that's okay, but just remember that you can't reference Wikipedia in your assignments because it can be edited by anyone, so it can't necessarily be a trusted source of information. Can be okay just to get a little bit of background information if you want to get started there. You need to develop your keywords, and when we say keywords, we don't just mean the actual keywords in the question, but also what could be some synonyms for those keywords. So words that mean the same thing, that are around the same topic, that you can look out for when you're doing your research. Now, if I click on it, it gives me a specific activities that I can do. So when you're trying to understand the question, the first thing you could try and do is to write it in your own words. I used to love doing that because if I put it in my own words, it means that I am actually understanding what the question is asking of me. And then identify the key terms, and it gives you some examples there. If we go back and have a look at the second step, this locate information and select resources, this is probably what you spend the most time on when you're doing your research. Defining the task is really important to get that foundation, but realistically, the most time is spent on these two areas here. So if we click on locate information, the second step, once we've had a go at defining the task, and we can see here it breaks it down for us. So when we're searching the web, some tips and tricks for searching the web, using keywords, how do you actually use keywords to your benefit? Finding primary sources online, things like that. So if I click on the first one, it just gives a really nice overview about search engines, different tips and tricks that you can use when using things like Google. We're going to delve more deeply into that in the next episode, but this does give a great overview to begin with. Okay, I hope you found today's episode useful. It's just a quick one showing you how to find that Ergo website, click on the research skills, follow those six steps. It makes it much easier when you can break it down like that. Hope to see you at the next episode. Thanks, everyone.